spectacular evening. What a spectacular performance. Welcome all. I am Joan Abramson, CalArts trustee, and the proud parent of one of today's MFA graduates. On behalf of our chairman, Jim Disney, and our entire board of trustees, I bring congratulations to the graduating BFA, MFA, MA, and DMA candidates of 2016. Congratulations as well to the many relatives, parents, friends gathered here today who have supported today's graduates on the long and sometimes difficult journey that has brought them to this happy day. As a longtime trustee of CalArts, I've been privileged to witness the creative labors, collaborative energy, and fierce commitment of CalArts students to their craft. Today, we celebrate your hard work, intrepid imagination, far-reaching intelligence, necessary resourcefulness, and your persistence in the face of many obstacles that you overcame at every turn. I know that you will never stop striving for beauty and insight as you reach for your dreams. Remember to thank your family and mentors for their support, patience, and encouragement. But when all is said and done, what will nurture you and carry you into the future are the bonds you have forged with your fellow students as you launch yourselves into careers that you love. I wear my wish for you not on my sleeve, but upon my skirt. Let the words run through your veins and let the colors fill your mind until there's nothing to do but explode. And it is now my pleasure to introduce Brian Harlan, Associate Provost of CalArts.
Okay. I know we're here tonight to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2016. I just want to take just a moment to remember some of the people that brought you to this stage tonight. First of all, I want everyone, all of us, to thank the staff, the CalArts staff. These are people that scoured the globe to recruit you, that admitted you and worked with you on financial aid, that registered you, that student affairs, business office, all these people that made this possible. They painted the walls after your exhibition. They cleaned up after the Halloween party. Okay? We also need to remember and thank, and I'm sure you will, your amazing faculty. The amazing faculty who custom tailored your curriculum and met with you individually as mentors, one-on-one throughout the semester, who challenged and inspired you. And we need to pay a special tribute to a few people that are retiring tonight. Maddie Schrader from Critical Studies, Barry Schrader from Music, and Mary Lou Rosato from Theater. These are some of the people that made CalArts special, that really creates what CalArts is. And finally, I want all of the CalArts graduates to help me thank some of the people, their friends and family, your partners, your everyone who helped you, who encouraged you from the very beginning, who supported you and ran various psychic interference throughout your time here. These are the people that really made this possible. So please, CalArts graduates, help me in thanking the staff, faculty, and family and friends, and everybody that made this possible. Thank you. And now I want to bring to the stage, it's my honor to bring to the stage two exemplars of the student union. Liz Hoos, who's the Vice President of Student Union. And Olga Cosme, the Student Union Trustee.
Changes that were going to happen. I look around and am proud to call myself part of the 2016 graduating class, and it is filled with some of the most talented people I know.
To tell you the truth, for the last few weeks, Liz and I have wondered what we could tell you guys to prepare you guys for the road that lies ahead, knowing we were just graduates ourselves. And the truth is, we don't know what lies ahead, but as college students, we're well equipped in knowing the unknown.
We have grown accustomed to the fear, the restless nights, the anxiety that comes with exploring the unknown. Like many parents here today, we too have lied in bed wondering what we will do with our degrees and whether the investment was worth it. Unless, of course, your child's an animator, and then you pretty much don't have to worry about anything. So the likelihood is they already have a job waiting for them.
But for the rest of us, no matter how much we wish it otherwise, life does not offer reassurances as to what lies ahead. Life, much like making art, is a process. It leads us to places we never thought we would go. It makes us answer questions we feared facing. And it pairs us with people that end up changing the way we view the world.
I, for one, no wonder longer whether my time here was worth it. As I look out and see my peers and faculty, the people I have come to call family, I know that no matter what battles we will have to face, there was a purpose in what we accomplished here. Like when a few students gave everyone norovirus, that was a shitty experience. They shut down the CalArts Halloween party to avoid more students being infected, but it ended up with spur-of-the-moment smaller house parties. Anywhere else, that would have been a disaster. However, here at CalArts, we call that teamwork. Personally, my time at CalArts has changed me for the better. It's made me a better artist, a better person, and it's given me a different perspective on life.
So if you're still wondering what you're going to do with your degree, why not try changing the world for size? As artists, we do what others wish they could. We tell stories. We're in the business of making people feel something, of moving them, of connecting people they otherwise would have never crossed paths with. The life of an artist isn't easy, nor is it one that can be chosen. It's a gift that merits respect and dedication, and truly what a privilege it has been to be able to spend these years with people who also share that gift with us.
I'd like to say something to our parents now. Thank you. Thank you for putting up with us over the past couple years. I know it hasn't been easy, however, I want to warn you. We are artists, and although it may be hard to understand what we do, we are trying our best. We didn't choose the most traditional route, but we're ready to work. You need to be proud of your graduate. We worked hard to get here. I know that we'll be working hard for the rest of our lives. We chose to do something we love, and that we have put our all in, and we will continue to. And although success may not be immediate, we are ready to work hard, as we know it won't be easy.
In closing, we'd like to thank all of our faculty members who have been with us from the beginning. More than just mentoring, you have worn your hearts on your sleeves. You've cried with us, problem solved with us, challenged us to be better, and accepted us even when we cannot accept ourselves. If you've not heard it before, or just not enough, we thank you. Now it's our honor and great privilege to introduce the president of CalArts, Steven Lavine.
Hear this a lot today. Congratulations. You've completed 2, 3, 4 years at CalArts, some of you 5, 6, 7, 8. You've had ups and downs, good reviews and not such good ones. You've made work that was not just practice, but was already the real thing. And tonight you cross the finish line, enjoy it, take pride in the work you've accomplished, thank the many people who've helped you get this far. But we call this commencement for a reason, because even after all you've already done, this is just the beginning, and indeed, many of you are already deep into what comes next. One of the great pleasures in being president of CalArts is running into alumni as they make their way into the world. And I can tell you that there's nowhere in the world you will go where you won't encounter other CalArts alumni. You come from 40 countries and virtually all 50 states, and now you will carry your creativity, sensitivity, and skills around the globe. You will find as you encounter other CalArts alumni that you share deep bonds of experience, attitude, and ideals, even if you're from different fields, even if you're from different generations at CalArts. Seek out those other graduates. If you need help, they will be the primary resource for you. And if you're in a position to help someone else, do it. In my experience, kindness and generosity are almost always rewarded, although sometimes it takes a while. This is my 29th commencement. Each one, my wife Janet Sternberg, a writer and photographer, has been here with me. We've shared the joy in this occasion. And this could turn out to be my last one, since I will be stepping down as president next year. And by this time, there may have been a new president selected who may want to give this speech next year. So I want to take a few minutes to tell you what I've learned over 28 years about the lives of artists, and that means about the life of everyone. When I arrived at CalArts, I brought with me the common vision of the brave artist, working alone, insufficiently appreciated, shivering in an unheated apartment.
Oh my God.
Of course, I wasn't in Southern California then. In fact, what I've learned is that it does take bravery. But with any luck, you won't be working alone, but instead we'll be with other like-minded individuals, many of whom are sitting next to you today at graduation. And you won't be starving. You'll be living well, maybe not lavishly, You'll be working too hard, like pretty much everyone today. And you will be satisfied in your life and work more than people in almost any other occupation. The surveys say the only people who are happier in their work than artists are firemen and priests. You can figure that one out for yourselves. That doesn't mean there won't be rough spots, or that starting out as you will tomorrow is not difficult. At last week's character animation producer show, alumnus Rich Moore, the co-director most recently of Zootopia, spoke of the anger that he and his classmates felt when, after being at CalArts and proving they knew how to make films, they then had to start at the bottom of the industry and work their way up. And he said the anger ate away at them until they were ready to quit, but they didn't. And then one day the phone rang and he was offered the chance to be one of the three directors of The Simpsons on television, and his life began. It also doesn't mean you'll be doing precisely what today you think you will be doing. Indeed, you may find you're making your way in another area of your art, or in another art altogether, or in a capacity that's not in the arts at all, but draws on your abilities as creative problem solvers. That, in fact, is another thing I've learned. When I arrived 29 years ago, I thought of artists as drawing on a very distinct set of aptitudes, visual, verbal, kinesthetic, histrionic. What I've learned watching our alumni is that, yes, there are those special gifts, but equally important, and I hope what you've developed at CalArts, are your abilities as creative problem solvers. As you go to Forward, you will discover other gifts as well, of which you are now only dimly aware or don't know how to value. A talent for friendship, or for leadership, or for persistence, or resilience. Indeed, you'll find that even qualities you see as drawbacks can be marshaled to your advantage. In my case, I am quite indecisive, which makes me a slow decision maker, which is supposed to be a terrible thing in a leader. However, the fact that it takes me time to make up my mind means that I listen to other people and to contrary positions and often come out in a better place. You'll find the same way that parts of yourselves that you think are the problem may very well turn out to be the solution in this next phase in your lives. Together, your distinct artistic aptitude, your abilities as creative problem solvers, and those other talents will combine to open paths you do not even imagine. A graduate of our I noticed as I read this over just now that I only describe one career actually in the arts here, but most of them are in the arts. A graduate of our jazz program has become a serial entrepreneur. When I asked him how he did it, he told me that what he does is, after all, only structured improvisation. One of today's honorary degree recipients, theater school alum Don Cheadle, just now, not only acted the part of Miles Davis in his new film, but when he couldn't find others who shared his vision for what the film should be, he wrote it and directed it as well, even though he had never directed a film before. Steve Hillenburg studied marine biology as an undergraduate. I doubt that when he graduated in that field, and came to CalArts as an animator, he had any inkling that SpongeBob SquarePants would be the mixture of marine biology and animation. what are the pleasures of watching you as you go forward, and I hope this is a pleasure you'll take in your own lives, is discovering the ways that the unique set of capacities, which is you, takes you places you never imagined. I've always been shy, and I thought the right course for me was to be a literary scholar. Us shy people are often most happy along with books. And so I became an English professor. I could not have predicted then that I'd end up as one of the longest serving college presidents in the United States, which means spending all your time with other people. I won't bore you with how my aptitudes and abilities, such as they are, came together, but they did, and have given me a life richer than I could ever have imagined, although I do note that it is the life my mother would have wished for herself if she'd had the opportunity. You'll also find yourself rising to meet challenges different and bigger than you imagined possible. For me, that was the Northridge earthquake, which closed down pretty much all our campus, except for some offices and Chouinard dormitory, and required that we move all our programs in a two-week period to other buildings, and that somehow we raised $40 million to rebuild CalArts. At first, I was paralyzed. There was no book I could turn to tell me what to do when you've lost almost everything. But you pull yourself together, gather friends and colleagues around you, think hard about how to break the huge challenge into smaller ones, and then just do it, putting one step in front of the other until you are there. You know, you always imagine, I'm almost done. Well, there's lots more I'd like to tell you. I always imagine, or most of us always imagine, there are others who really know what they are doing. And there are certain things that one learns from experience. But mostly everyone is just drawing on the particular aptitudes, capacities, and experiences they bring to a situation, and then making it up as they go. When I arrived at CalArts, I'd done very little to make me think I could be a college president. Up to that point, I'd never led any kind of organization. As I took up the job, I received some valuable advice from other college presidents, but I never met the president who really knew what he was doing. Which means, and this is why I say this, that there's never a reason to be intimidated by the greats in your field. Respectful, yes. Ready to learn from what they know, yes. But not intimidated. It also means it almost never hurts to admit ignorance and to seek assistance. And that almost always, people will be flattered you asked, even when they don't know the answer to your questions. Above all, I want to say to you that, as CalArtsians, you are unique and enormously valuable individuals. The world needs you. I once asked a stop motion animation student who built a fabulously detailed wooden castle as his set whether he'd grown up learning carpentry. When he said no, I asked, how did you do this then? And he said, I go to CalArts. I just did it. Combine that spirit with the desire to make a humanly valuable contribution to the world, and the future will open before you. when I first arrived at CalArts in 1988 and saw the work that students were doing, I was impressed. Frankly, I was intimidated, although I know I just told you never to be intimidated. For three decades, CalArts students and alumni have filled me with admiration. Sorry. Moment to collect myself. I wish you rich, fulfilling, creative lives. Stay in touch, grapple your friends to you, and help them in every way you can. Wherever I find myself, I'll be watching with pride and admiration. Congratulations. Graduation to offer honorary degrees to one or two individuals who represent the kind of accomplishment, artistic and human, that we wish for you today. I want to invite up the first of our honorary degree recipients, and I'm very proud this year that one is a former faculty member and one is an alumnus. I want to invite up first Ishmael Wadada Leo Smith. Smith, as a trumpeter and multi-instrumentalist, composer and improviser, you've actively created contemporary music for more than 40 years. You have few peers in the idiom of shifting instrumental colors and thematically oriented improvisations. Coda magazine described you as one of the most vital musicians on the planet today. Born in Leland, Mississippi, you played in high school concert and marching bands. And at 13, you became involved with the Delta Blues and improvisation music traditions. Your formal training began with your stepfather, Alex Wallace, and developed with the U.S. military band program at the Sherwood School of Music and at Wesleyan University. Your work as an educator includes your 20 years on the faculty of CalArts, where you coordinated the African American Improvisational Music Program with the Performer-Composer Program. You've taught also at the University of New Haven, at the Creative Music Studio in Woodstock, New York, and at Bard College. Your systemic music language, which I'm going to try to pronounce, you told me how, Ankaras Mason, Andras Mason, has proved significant in both your development as an artist and as an educator. Since 1967, all of your compositions, improvisations, and music have employed systems of rhythmic units, melodic sonic units, and symbolic units, which are realized only in the context of music score and performance. In 2013, your contemporary classical work, 10 Freedom Summers, 19 pieces of abstract expression focusing on the key moments in the civil rights movement, received widespread acclaim and was named a finalist for the Pulitzer Prize in Music. A member of the Association for the Advancement of Creative Musicians, your awards and commissions include, it's a long list. It's a very long list. Ishmael Wadada Leo Smith, we honor you today for your many significant contributions to world culture, for your work as a musician and an educator, for your career-long commitment to the creative imagination and advance of the art of improvisation, for your belief in music as a social good, and for your singular contribution to the history of CalArts. With the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and upon the recommendation of the faculties of the California Institute of the Arts, I hereby confer on you the degree of Doctor of the Arts, honoris causa, together with all the rights, benefits, and privileges appertaining thereto. Leo, congratulations.
Good afternoon. I'd like to thank Steven, the president of CalArts, the faculty, the deans, and most of all the students, all of you. And I'd like to also offer a special thanks to my family. They all have come from Connecticut to see their dad and granddad receive this. I have just two statements to read to you. You may kind of understand them or you may not. That's not important. But I'm going to play something for you. And in art, understanding is overrated. What's important about art is that you actually experience it. And once you experience it, you can never ever lose it. You won't have to try to find it again because it's part of your main consciousness. And like and dislikes, those are kinds of ways of thinking about stuff that don't really exist. Because what happened to an experience? You cannot just like it or dislike it. It influences your life forever. So this is what I have to say. Art is about the artist who has something inside that is greater than the outside world. And by allowing the creative inspiration to be expressed, it makes the world greater. The true artist will always find a way to radicalize their art at every stage in their artistic journey. Although we live in this monstrous world of violence, hostility, and exploitation, still it is our responsibility to overcome these challenges by making art that will remain rooted in the practice of love and have the authority in that work to touch the hearts of human beings.
Don Cheadle up to the smile and said, "Steve, I'm an actor."
Yeah.
Tells you something about his acting. You have illuminated screens large and small with extraordinary acting that ranges from searing intensity to the sort of disarmingly casual, while always maintaining a kind of magnetic specificity. Your interpretation of each
That's what I do.
I'll leave out all the other good parts. Your interpretation of each role manifests a remarkable creative intelligence. You know what each project needs most. After graduating from the CalArts School of Theater, you broke out in the mid-1990s with a series of indelible characterizations. The incorrigible mouse and devil in the blue dress, Sylvester Carrier and Rosewood, Buck Swope and the Boogie Nights. Maurice and Steven Soderbergh's Out of Sight, and Sammy Davis Jr. in HBO's The Rat Pack, which won your first Golden Globe. Hotel Rwanda, Hotel Rwanda in 2004 featured your Academy Award nominated performance as the real-life hotel manager who courageously acted upon his conscience in the midst of the Rwandan genocide. Your staggering depiction ventured into the extreme edges of human experience between absolute evil and life-saving empathy. Elsewhere, you continued your collaboration with Soderbergh in Traffic and the Oceans Trilogy. And you went on to star in the Oscar-winning LA ensemble drama Crash, which you also produced. And Talk to Me, with its electrifying portrayal of radio personality and community activist, Petey Green. You've since joined the Marvel Pantheon as Rhodey, AKA War Machine. Appearing in four of the studio's blockbusters. You've also played to terrific effect the unscrupulous Marty Kahn in Showtime's Housewives. A live wire portrayal that has earned your second Golden Globe and a consecutive Emmy nominations every year since 2012. Most recently, and perhaps your most ambitious dramatic work today, arrived only months ago in Miles Ahead. This intensely felt portrait of jazz icon Miles Davis, premiered to a standing ovation at the New York Film Festival last fall. Bold storytelling, a mix of biography and subjective speculation, and your incandescent performance soared to the level of artistry demanded by a creative force as complex as Miles Davis. More than 6 years in the making, Miles Ahead was a labor of love. Or, in typical CalArts fashion, art that refused to be stopped. When the project could not engage the right director and screenwriter, you took on those roles yourself. The deep personal dedication recalls your earlier experience of making Hotel Rwanda, which led you to embark on a tireless campaign to stop the genocide in Darfur, which included co-authoring the book Not On Our Watch, The Mission to End Genocide in Darfur and Beyond. You co-founded Not On Our Watch Project, which mobilizes global attention and resources against mass atrocities and leverage your visibility to advance other projects of conscience. Black Entertainment Television honored you your ongoing activism with the Humanitarian of the Year Award, while the United Nations Environment Program, recognizing your commitment to its cause, has named you a Goodwill Ambassador. Don Cheadle, this is one of the fun parts of my job. Don Cheadle, the CalArts community is proud to recognize your exceptional work and to honor you accordingly. With the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and on the recommendation of the faculties of the California Institute of the Arts, I hereby present you with your second CalArts degree, Doctor of Arts, Honoris Causa, together with all the rights, benefits, and privileges that appertain thereto. Congratulations.
Thank you all so much. I mean, you just did it, but give yourselves a big round of applause, please. I remember sitting where you guys were sitting. Actually, I wasn't where you guys were sitting, because we did it on the other side when I was here. I'm the class of 1986, so most of you graduated when I was even on the planet at the time. But there's a familiar aroma in the air. That tells me that things haven't changed all that much. I'm very glad to be here. I'd like to say thank you to Stephen. Thank you to the faculty and the staff, and thank you students. As an alum of CalArts, I can say that 100% I wouldn't be where I am had I not had my experience here for those 4 years. And I still have amazing friends to this day that I met at CalArts, and we continue to be support systems for one another and to push and challenge each other every day. So I have this school to thank for that, and hopefully you guys will too. And then everyone has said so many amazing things already about art, some of the truest words that have ever been spoken. Thank you. And I'm going to read a statement from someone who I think is one of the greatest artists we've ever seen on this planet. And this is something that I go back to year after year. And every year I feel like I understand it a little better. But no one said it better to me than Martha Graham. There is a vitality, a life force, a quickening that is translated through you into action. And there is only one of you in all time. This expression is unique, and if you block it, it will never exist through any other medium, and it be lost. The world will not have it. It is not your business to determine how good it is, not how it compares with other expression. It is your business to keep it yours clearly and directly, to keep the channel open. You have to keep open and aware directly to the urges that motivate you. Keep the channel open. No artist is pleased. There is no satisfaction, whatever, at any time. There is only a queer, divine dissatisfaction, a blessed unrest that keeps us marching and makes us more alive than the others. You will face adversity. You will face challenges. You will hear no's. You will hear not so much. Pull all of those things in. Allow them to feed your art. Allow them to light a fire under you. Allow them to challenge you, to continue to press, to make your voice heard. Art is vital, never more than today, in the world as we see, with the violence that we're facing, the challenges, the obstinate nature of people's opinions, the inability to see across the aisle. So please, keep at it. Art changes lives, it changes minds, it changes opinions, it changes cultures, it changes people, it changes ideas, it changes voices, it changes perspective, it changes humanity. Keep at it. You guys are shit, please.
Graduating students to rise. This is the moment when we actually confer the degree. With the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and upon the recommendation of the faculties of the California Institute of the Arts, I hereby confer upon you the degrees of Bachelor of Fine Arts, Master of Fine Arts, Master of Arts, or Doctor of Musical Arts, together with all the rights, benefits, and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations.